Hey there!
Alright, so before starting this episode, a few things that are really important. The first one is regarding subtitles. You notice since a few episodes that I have friends around that speak French, so when I'm with them, I speak French, but I put subtitles on my videos, so no need to put like an happy comment in the comment section. Some comments are really rude, and it hurts. That's not cool. First, I speak English most of the time, and second, I spend countless hours putting subtitles on these episodes, so just learn how to turn them on. You just go in this corner and click the CC button, and you'll have closed caption, which means subtitles, appearing at the bottom of your screen to follow when I'm speaking in French or in another language. If you don't find the English subtitles, just click same thing on this corner, on the small wheel, kind of, and there you can select the language you want the subtitles. I put myself French and English subtitles on in all my episodes, and then I received the help of some of you, some of the subscribers that helped me also doing Russian, Spanish, German version. And if you tomorrow want to translate it in Chinese, Arabic, or whatever language, please get in touch with me and we'll see how we can do this. The second thing, really important, you can definitely help me by just sharing this video, give it a like and subscribe, it will really help me. And finally, I think, and maybe it's the most important, you recently passed 40,000 subscribers on this channel and this is pretty amazing. Thank you so much for the support, keep sharing it and hope you enjoy this episode. Hey, the Sailing Frenchman. In the last episode, you got all romantic about all that travel bullshit. So don't you dare start again, and let's go back to real pirate sailing, would you?
Après une grosse nave de quoi? Une bonne demi-heure?
Ouais.
Une bonne demi-heure. On a dû faire 2000 peinards. Et on est arrivé.
Comment ça s'appelle?
Fiddling, le mouillage.
Fiddling.
C'est quoi l'île?
Terre de bas.
Terre de bas.
Et on est pas mal du tout. Et là, ils nous font pas payer les bouées, donc on est peinards. Bon, Lulu, qu'est-ce que tu fais?
Je dépiote ma pêche.
Bon, t'as un peu tué un enfant là, mais à part ça, franchement, bravo. Du premier coup.
Parce que du coup, c'est plus dur à viser aussi.
Ouais. On va pas mettre ça sur le compte de la chance du tout.
Non. C'est technique.
Et tu l'as bien écaillé?
Ouais.
Ça, c'est le reste de la pêche. Des petits rougets pour tout le monde. Okay, so here we are in Terre de Bas. The boat is over there and we're going for a run to the mountain all the way there with Lucy. If she waited for me, I'm not sure. Let's see it up. She's really competitive and she's starting to try to find excuses. Allez, vas-y, cours. Et les sportifs doucement.
Pas de la papillote.
Ça roule ou quoi?
C'est parfait.
On est sur le coup. Des petits rougets. On va être bien bien bien. Une petite sauce tomate et du riz, cimer.
Cruising with two small boats together is really fun. For a few days, we've been sailing alongside, went fishing, gathered provision, cooking and having food on each other's boat, taking turns. And when other cruisers were running into us on shore, we were normally referred as the young lads from the small sailing boats, which I guess was pretty accurate.
So today we are going back to the main island in Les Saintes, and it's the final race because Lucy has been with her little boat over there. She's been waiting every time we tried to race, but I was towing this big dinghy.
Since two episodes, you might have noticed that I have a really nice dinghy and not my usual inflatable kayak. This is because when the boat from my friend went missing, they had only the dinghy left. And since they were flying back home, they asked me to take care of the dinghy and bring it back to Martinique, where they wanted to store it. It was awesome to have a nice dinghy, especially since we were several people on board at that point, but that was also a really pain in the neck, slowing the boat down big time.
So today, the guys are taking the dinghy. It's not long, it's maybe 2 miles. They're going to do the committee boat and media boat at the same time. And so we're going to try to race over there. So finger crossed for me, and I'm going to leave the GoPro with the guys.
Okay, so we are going to the regatta. Making the regatta della Peperoni.
Regardez cette force de la nature qui remonte son ancre à bout de bras.
Ok, affalé de l'ossette.
Là, on est parti pour aller chercher Lulu parce qu'en fait, elle est pas du tout dans la bonne trajectoire. Elle. On a retrouvé la grosse Lulu, la bretonne.
Hé hey Lulu, rien de perdu.
La Bretagne reprend la tête sur le piémont pyrénéen, la Bretagne reprend la main. Regardez cet anti-fouling magnifique. C'est grâce à ça qu'Hugo reprend la tête. Regardez, regardez, regardez comme il la possède, la Bretagne se fait endormir.
Donc voilà l'équipe du comité d'organisation ainsi que comité médiatique. De pain de sucre
et de l'îlet Cabri que vous voyez là-bas derrière. Nous attendons nos deux concurrents. Hugo a pris une certaine avance, mais nous pouvons quand même relever Lulu, hein, parce que option tactique, elle a choisi son itinéraire à elle. Plus de vent, plus de mer, un beau combat. Nous assistons à un combat de Birmain. Xavier Lara parmi nous, comité directeur, comité d'organisation, comité médiatique. Xavier Lara, ancienne équipe de France de voile qui courait sur les 4-7, dirait-il, hein, comme il le dit si bien. Il a longtemps participé à la préparation des Jeux Olympiques du Rio 2024 ou 2012, je ne sais plus. Ok, nous reviendrons sur l'introduction de Xavier plus tard. Nous avons El Capitaine. qui est là. Il est là. Il fend la bise, comme on dirait.
Prenez un vrai cousin. Oh, c'est tellement beau, hein.
La Bretagne est dans le match, deuxième. C'est quand même le Piémont pyrénéen qui reste chaud patate. Allez Lulu, on y va Lulu, c'est parti. Fais-nous un beau virement de bord. Alors, et le bulot, il est là-bas, oui, regardez-le.